Welcome to an intro to hyperbolic functions. In this video, we'll define the hyperbolic functions, graph the hyperbolic functions, and also state the properties of hyperbolic functions. Hyperbolic functions are exponential functions, but they share similar properties to trigonometric functions. Right away, notice how there are six hyperbolic functions, and there are also six trig functions. But notice each hyperbolic function is defined using exponential functions. So if we wanted to evaluate a hyperbolic function, we would just substitute the given value of x into the exponential function and then simplify. But notice how if we compare the hyperbolic sine function defined here and the hyperbolic cosecant function defined here, notice how the functions are reciprocals of one another, just like the sine and cosecant trig functions. And notice that the hyperbolic cosine function defined here and the hyperbolic secant function defined here are also reciprocals of one another, just like the cosine and secant trig function values are reciprocals of one another. And then finally, the hyperbolic tangent function defined here and the hyperbolic cotangent function defined here are also reciprocals of one another. Now let's talk about why they're called hyperbolic functions. We know if we have a point where the x-coordinate is cosine t, and the y-coordinate is sine t, the point would fall on the unit circle, or the circle x squared plus y squared equals 1, pictured here. Similarly, if we have a point where the x-coordinate is hyperbolic cosine of t, and the y-coordinate is hyperbolic sine of t, the point would be on the hyperbola x squared minus y squared equals 1. Again, notice the similarities between the trig functions and the hyperbolic functions. And because these points are on a hyperbola, this is the reason why they're called the hyperbolic functions. Now let's take a look at the graph of each hyperbolic function. The blue graph here is the graph of the hyperbolic sine function. Notice how I've also graphed two exponential functions. This graph here is the graph of y equals e to the power of x divided by 2. And this red graph here is the graph of y equals negative e to the power of negative x divided by 2. Notice how the sum of these two exponential functions make up the definition of the hyperbolic sine function. Therefore, if we add these red function values, we would obtain the blue function values, which gives us the graph of the hyperbolic sine function graphed here in blue. And now if we take a look at the graph of the reciprocal function, or the hyperbolic cosecant function, and compare it to the graph of the hyperbolic sine function graphed here in red, the function values of the blue graph, or hyperbolic cosecant, are the reciprocal function values of the hyperbolic sine function graphed here in red. For example, notice when the hyperbolic sine function is equal to 2, here the hyperbolic cosecant function is equal to 1/2, and when the hyperbolic sine function is equal to negative 2, here notice how the hyperbolic cosecant function is equal to negative 1/2. Also notice when x equals 0, we have a vertical asymptote. Now if we look at the hyperbolic cosine function and also compare it to the graph of y equals e to the power of x divided by 2 and y equals e to the power of negative x divided by 2, again, if we add these exponential functions, which is the definition of the hyperbolic cosine function, we would have the graph of the hyperbolic cosine function. So again, if we add the red function values, we would obtain the blue function values, which would give us the graph of the hyperbolic cosine function. Now let's take a look at the reciprocal of the hyperbolic cosine function, which would be the graph of the hyperbolic secant function graphed here in blue. Again, if we compare the red function values and the blue function values, they're reciprocals of one another because the red graph is the graph of the hyperbolic cosine function. And now the blue graph here is the graph of the hyperbolic tangent function. Notice how it has two horizontal asymptotes, one at y equals 1 and one at y equals negative 1. Now I've also graphed in red the hyperbolic sine function and hyperbolic cosine function. It's more difficult to tell, but if we find the ratio of the red function values, it would give us the blue function values, or the hyperbolic tangent function values, which are graphed here in blue. And then the last graph will be the graph of the hyperbolic cotangent function, which we see here. And if we compare the blue graph to the red graph, the red function values and the blue function values, again, are reciprocals of one another. Notice how this graph has a vertical asymptote at x equals 0, as well as two horizontal asymptotes, again at y equals 1 and y equals negative 1. Now that we've briefly reviewed the graphs of the six hyperbolic functions, let's take a look at some additional properties of hyperbolic functions. And again, these properties here should remind us of similar trig function properties. In the next few videos, we will prove several of these properties using the definitions of the hyperbolic functions. But I do want to end on talking about one of the main reasons why hyperbolic functions are so important. A catenary is a curve formed by a hanging cable or chain under its own weight when supported only at its ends. So for example, the chain in this picture is forming a catenary, and a catenary is formed by a hyperbolic function. It's often mistaken for a parabola formed by a quadratic function, but it's not, it's actually a catenary formed by a hyperbolic function. So whenever you see a power line or a phone line being supported at two ends, the shape of that graph would be a catenary formed by a hyperbolic function, not formed by a quadratic function. And just to emphasize the differences, if we look at this graph here, the red graph forms a catenary formed by a hyperbolic function, and the blue graph forms a parabola formed by a quadratic function. So while they are similar, again, if we have a hanging cable or chain under its own weight, the shape would be the red graph, which is formed by a hyperbolic function. Okay, I hope you found this intro video helpful. Thank you for watching.